Here we'll take a look at how to find the mean, median, and mode on a variable. And in this example, we have the variable exam score. And notice there are 15 different people on this variable. So we have 15 different exam scores. Now to obtain the mean, the median, and the mode, we'll go ahead and go to Analyze, and then Descriptive Statistics. And now many users would think that they could use one of these two options, either descriptives or frequencies. Now descriptives, the problem with this choice, if you chose descriptives, is that you can only obtain the mean through this menu command. To obtain the mean, the median, and the mode, we'll need to select, or we'll want to select, frequencies. So go ahead and click on that. And then we have a variable exam score, and we want to move that to the right, to the variables box, and then select statistics. Now under statistics, notice to the right here we see central tendency. And notice how mean, median, and mode is presented. So we want to go ahead and check all of those. And I'll just check the sum as well since I'm there. Go ahead and click continue. And then I'm going to deselect this display frequencies tables box so I don't get a frequency table as well since that's not of interest for this analysis. So go ahead and check on that to deselect it. And then click OK. Now here we get our output, and notice we have this one table on exam score. We have 15 observations, 0 are missing, meaning we have data on all 15 people. And then we have the mean, median, and mode presented. The mean, rounding to 2 decimal places, is 83.53. The median is 87. And the mode is 93. And the sum is 1,253. So as a brief review of these measures of central tendency, the mean is the arithmetic average. The median is the middle score, also known as the 50th percentile. And the mode is the most frequently occurring score in the data set. Okay, so that's it. To obtain the mean, median, and mode in SPSS, once again, you just want to go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, and then Frequencies, and select the appropriate options, and you'll have the three measures of central tendency.